वेलकम बैक क्लास टू द सेकेंड चैप्टर ऑफ शंकर आयश बुक इन्वायरमेंट. सेकेंड चैप्टर इज़ फंक्शंस ऑफ एन इकोसिस्टम. सो इफ़ यू आर फेसिंग एनी प्रॉब्लम रिगार्डिंग गवर्नमेंट एग्जामिनेशंस, यू कैन विजिट आवर वेबसाइट्स exammap.com एंड isbio.com, एंड यू कैन ऑल्सो कॉन्टेक्ट अस ऑन आर व्हाट्सएप नंबर. सो लेट्स स्टार्ट. फर्स्ट वन इज एनर्जी फ्लो. So energy is the basic force responsible for all metabolic activities. All we know that to do work we need energy, and energy comes from the food that we consume. And the flow of energy is from the producer to the top consumer is called energy flow, and it is unidirectional. Means energy flows from the producer to the top consumer, not from the consumer to the producer. No, it is unidirectional, that is from producers to top consumer. And the study of trophic level interaction in an ecosystem gives an idea about the energy flow through the system. Energy flows through the trophic levels from the producers to subsequent trophic levels, and this energy always from lower producer to higher trophic level, and it never flows in reverse direction, that is from carnivorous to herbivorous to the producers. There is a loss of some energy in the form of unusable heat at each trophic level, so that energy level decreases. From first trophic level to upward trophic level. So there are trophic level concepts. There are three concepts which involves in trophic level interaction. First one is food chain, that organisms in ecosystem are related to each other through feeding mechanism or trophic levels, or one organisms become food for other. Food web, it is the combination of many food chains and ecological pyramids. We have different ecological pyramids. So let's discuss first one, food chain. A food chain starts with producers and ends with top carnivores. The sequence of eaten and being eaten produces transfer of heat as energy, and it is known as food chain. So we have some examples of the food chain, that small herbivores. First we have plant that converts solar energy into chemical energy by the photosynthesis. Then small herbivores consume the plant matter. Herbivores consume the plant matters and convert them into animal matter, and these herbivores eaten by the large carnivores. So we have types of food chains. There's example that first we have grass, and it is consumed by the grasshopper, which is primary consumer. Then it is consumed by secondary consumer is mice, and then mice is eaten by the tertiary consumer, which is snake, and it is eaten by final consumer, that is hawk or eagle. So we have two types of food chain. First one is grazing food chain. In grazing food chains, consumers which start the food chain utilizing the plant or plant part. Grazing food chain means the consumers starts the food chain with the plant or the part of the plant as their food and constitute the grazing food chain. This food chain begins from the green plants at the base. And the top consumer is herbivorous. For example, in terrestrial ecosystem, grass is eaten by a caterpillar. Then which is eaten by lizard, and lizard is eaten by snake. एंड इन एक्वाटिक इकोसिस्टम फाइटोप्लांक्टन्स दैट आर प्राइमरी प्रोड्यूसर्स फाइटोप्लांक्टन्स eaten by zooplanktons which is eaten by fishes then fishes eaten by the pelicans or large fishes second one is detritus food chain this food chain starts from the dead organic matter of decaying animals from dead organic matter of decaying animals and plant bodies to the microorganisms and then to detritus feeding organisms these are called detritivores decomposers and to the other predators example litter eaten by the earthworm then is eaten by chicken and it is eaten by hog the distinction between these two food chain is the source of energy for the first level in the grazing food chain we saw that the first level of consumer is the plant or a part of plant and it in the detritus food chain is the dead organic matter of decaying animal or a plant body second one is food web a food web illustrates all possible transfers of energy and nutrients among the organisms in an ecosystem where a food chain traces only one pathway and different food chains make the food web Here is the example of food web. That here is the plant of corn, which is eaten by grasshopper, and grasshopper is eaten by frog, and rat is eaten by another python and snake and another one. These are making the food web. There is a transformation of energy like a web. Third one is ecological pyramids. The steps of the trophic levels expressed in diametric way are referred as ecological pyramids. And the food producer forms the base of the pyramid, and the top carnivore forms the tip of the ecological pyramid, and the other consumers lie between these trophic levels. The pyramid consists of a number of horizontal bars. Depicting specific trophic levels which are arranged sequentially from primary producer level through herbivore and carnivore onwards the length of each bar represents the total number of individuals at each trophic level in an ecosystem so we have three categories in the ecological pyramid of numbers pyramid of biomass and pyramid of energy or productivity first one is pyramid of numbers this deals with the relationship between numbers of primary producers and consumers of different levels it is a graphic representation of total number of individuals of different species belonging to each trophic level in an ecosystem and depending upon the size and biomass the pyramid of numbers may not always be upright and may even be completely inverted so first one pyramid of numbers upright in this pyramid number of individuals decreased from lower level to higher level and this type of pyramid can be seen in grassland ecosystem this is the example of pyramid of numbers that first at the first trophic level producer this is of terrestrial ecosystem and this is the example of aquatic ecosystem so at the producer we have grasses in the large amount then it decreasing to the upward then we have insects then lizards then hawks and in the aquatic ecosystem we have firstly phytoplanktons eaten by zooplankton then these are eaten by small fishes and these are eaten by large fishes pyramid of numbers inverted second type In this type of pyramid, the number of individuals is increased from the trophic level to the higher level, means we have lower at the base and the higher at the top. A count in a forest would have a small number of large producers, for example few number of big trees, and this is because the tree primary producer, and it represents the different types of trophic levels, and it is followed by the different animals, herbivorous or carnivorous or producer or consumers, and resulting pyramid is an inverted shape. A pyramid of numbers does not take into account the fact that the size of organism being counted in each trophic level vary. It is very difficult to count all organisms in a pyramid of numbers, so the pyramid of number does not completely define the trophic structure for an ecosystem. Here we have the picture that at the base we have trees and it is increasing. We have lower at the base and greater amount we have at the top. Then herbivores are birds, parasites, and then hyperparasites. Second one is of pyramid of biomass. Pyramid of biomass, in order to overcome the shortcomings of pyramid of numbers, the pyramid of biomass is used, and in this approach individual in each trophic level are weighed instead of being counted. This gives us a pyramid of biomass, that is the total dry weight of all organisms at each trophic level at a particular time. Pyramid of biomass is usually determined by the collecting all organisms occupying each trophic level separately and measuring their dry weight. So in this type of pyramid of biomass, we will count the weights of the dry trophics. We will count the dry weight of all organisms at each trophic level. Pyramid of energy. To compare the functional roles of trophic levels in an ecosystem, an energy pyramid is more suitable. Energy pyramid reflects the laws of thermodynamics, that conversion of solar energy into chemical energy and heat energy at each trophic level, and with loss of energy being depicted at each trophic level to another trophic level. Hence the pyramid is always upward because energy is decreasing from downward to upward, and that is why it is always shows upward. So this is the figure. At the lowest level we have producer. Let's take example. Producer have the 1000 kilocalorie. Then it is eaten by the herbivore and we have the loss of the energy, and it remains only 100 kilocalorie. Then this is fed by the carnivores and have the only 10 kilocalorie energy, and at the top carnivores they only have the 1 kilocalorie. This is the loss of the energy. Let's have the pollutants and trophic levels. Pollutants, especially non-degradable ones, move through the various trophic levels in an ecosystem. Non-degradable pollutants means materials which cannot be metabolized by the living organisms. So first one is bioaccumulation. It refers to how pollutants enter a food chain. Bioaccumulation means how pollutants enters into a food chain, and in the bioaccumulation there is an increase in the concentration of pollutant from the environment to the first organism in a food chain. Second one is biomagnification, which refers to the tendency of pollutants to the concentrate as they move from one trophic level to the next. Thus, in biomagnification, there is an increase in the concentration of pollutant from one link in a food chain to another. Here is the example. The numbers here are the numbers which are representative values of concentration in the tissue of DDT and its derivatives. So we will back with the second part of this second chapter of functions of an ecosystem. Thank you, class.